Mom, let's see if we can figure out which of the following functions has a hole at 1, 4. Now, in order to have a hole at x equaling 1, you have to have a factor of x minus 1 in your numerator and denominator. So just taking a look here, I can see a does have a hole because it has x minus 1 common to the numerator and denominator, but b doesn't. I don't have that. Like, this is x minus 1, this is x plus 1. Those are different. So b is not my answer. And in that same vein, it's not C either because I only have an X minus 1 in the denominator. That would actually be a vertical asymptote. But take a look at D, right? We've got X minus 1 in the numerator and denominator. So we've got two functions here that do have holes at X equaling 1. But the question is, which one has the hole at 1, 4? So let's figure this out. This function basically looks like 1 over X minus 5. All right, and this one basically looks like 11x plus 1 over x plus 2. And where I'm getting that is I'm literally canceling out or dividing out that common factor that's in the numerator and denominator. So what I want to do is I want to plug x equaling 1 into both of these simplified functions, and then we'll see which one gives us back a y value of 4. So if f of x is approximately 1 over x minus 5, then f of 1, even though it's a whole, would have approximately been 1 over 1 minus 5. That would have been, what, 1 over negative 4? But that is not x equaling 4, so this is not the answer. All right, let's see here. If we had f of x was approximately 11x plus 1 over x plus 2, then f of 1, had it been there, it's not, it's a whole, but we're going to see what should have been there. This would have been 11 times 1 plus 1. Over 1 plus 2, what, that's 11 plus 1 over 3, that is 12 over 3, there it is, there's 4, so that is my answer. All right, thanks so much, everyone.